Hi guys, this is a demonstration for how to make a color wheel. And we're going to be using our watercolors, and we will need paint brushes and pick the one, probably the biggest one or the second biggest one. You'll need water in an old container. This is a dahi container. Make sure that your water is very far from your laptop. Okay, very important. And of course the arts process journal and a palette, an old plate. It can be a ceramic plate or a silver plate or a plastic plate or even a paper plate. Okay, to begin with, we're going to make a circle. Okay, and for that I'm going to use an old plate here. You can really make it with anything, but go ahead and find something to make a circular shape. And once you've got your circular shape, you want to be able to cut the circle in four parts, right? So let me just, and you can be very rough about this, doesn't have to be exact. So roughly in the middle, let me put a line there, and then roughly on the side, across from the left to the right, and put a line there. And then we want to split these into thirds. And again, you don't have to be too perfect, but you'll do it on one side here and then on the other side here, from here to here and from. So you want these three parts to be equal. You want these three parts to be equal. And then create a line across to create this kind of a pie made of, or a pizza made of these different parts. So this way we have six pizza pieces here and six pizza pieces there. All right, so once we have that, let us begin with our colors. Now these are watercolors, and we're going to make our color wheel with just three colors, with your primary colors, which are blue. So pick out the lighter blue if you've got a dark and a light blue. This is called cobalt blue. Pick a red, it doesn't really matter, but probably go with the Scarlet Lake if you have that. And then, of course, a yellow. And typically, you'll have only one yellow. All right, so once you have your three primary colors, what we're going to do is actually put them in three different parts of our plate. And I would say give yourself, so this would be the size of a pea, right? A little green pea that you eat, matar. This one, so we want about two peas worth of that, of the yellow. And then on the other side, we're going to put three of them. So you want to distribute them in three different parts on your palette. Do the same with the red. And then finally here with the blue. Okay, and there'll be a very specific way we're going to mix these up. A little technique that we're going to use. All right, so to start with, let us get our, I forgot to mention a rag. We always want a rag nearby. Okay, let us begin with yellow, all right? So the first yellow, the first wedge of our pizza, our color pizza, is going to be just pure yellow. So I dipped it in the water to make my brush a little bit, to make it wet, and I'm mixing that into one side of the paint here, okay? So I don't want the paint to be too thick, and I don't want it to be too runny. And I'm not gonna mix the whole thing as of yet. And let's just start towards the top. Okay, let me start with this side here. Okay, so I'm gonna use this brush. Now, one thing about painting is that you always wanna keep your wrist on something on the surface to bring stability to your stroke, right? And you may at different times want to actually turn around the paper so that, or the book, so that what you're doing is you're pulling the brush across. That way you get these nice kind of sharp edges, and then the middle you can just fill it up there, okay? So you're always kind of pulling the brush down towards you or a little bit to the side, but by pivoting your wrist on the book itself, it makes your hand really stable, and you can get some nice sharp edges that way. All right, now what are we going to do next? We're going to start mixing the yellow with the red, okay? But we're not going to yet go straight into the red. We're going to first create the orange that is between the yellow and the red. And what I will do is I'm going to pick up about one pea size worth of that and place it right here in the middle, like bang, halfway between these two colors, okay? And then I'm going to go in here and pick up some of the red. And it's not going to be as much because red is much more intense. So maybe one third or one quarter the size of that. And let me see what happens. And we don't always know for sure. Let me bring this up to the light. We've got some sunlight coming in from the side here, which is amazing, a miracle. That's the first sunlight I've seen in days. All right. So here we have an orange. It's a little bit closer to the, actually there's more yellow. So I should have put, we want that orange to be a little bit darker. At first you won't, maybe doesn't, may not, you may not be able to see it, but we're trying to get these, you're going to start, as you do this more and more, you'll understand what happens when you mix different amounts of different paints in, right? You get to be more quite familiar with the effects of various combinations of paint. Okay, so this is about what I want. I'm going to now pick up a little bit of water there, because I'm going to make this slightly dilute, and I'm going to go in and skip one pizza wedge and go to the next here. Okay, and I'm using my, again, I'm pivoting it, I'm keeping my wrist down, and let me finish this. The middle, you can be really kind of messy, and I'm going to actually now turn this around so that I can get this line here kind of nice and straight. Now you don't have to make it super perfect. My brush is a little bit dry, so I'm going to dip it in to the water, a little off my screen here, and go back in there and add this. It doesn't have to be perfect lines, but if you get, but you can, by holding it in the right way, you can end up getting a really clean line, really super easy. All right, now I'm going to go in and add the red. But, so notice here, I've got yellow, I've got the red, in the middle is the mixture of the two. Okay, so I'm going to clean my brush first, because I want my brush to be super clean. I don't want any of this orange to be in it, because I need to show the pure red. So I'm rubbing it against the bottom of the water container here, back and forth, okay, like that. And what that does, it helps the water get up into this area here, where the hair, the bristles, meets the metal. That's where you get a lot of paint stuck. And you want to get that really nice and clean up in there to make the paintbrush last longer, as well as so that the previous paint doesn't mix in and spoil the new paint that you're going to use. So I dip in a little bit, make my brush a little bit wet, and I'm going to add that wetness here to my watercolor paint here, because sometimes when watercolor paint comes out of the tube, it's a little bit thick. And I'm going to again skip this and go in and put down my red. Okay. And now it's getting a little bit dilute here, so I need to go in and pick up more color. So you want enough color on your brush so that you actually, so when you put the paint down, it looks fairly even. You don't really see the paper underneath, or you don't see a lot of lines. All right. So there we have it. Our primary color, yellow, another primary color, red, and in between, this is the secondary color, orange. It's that mixture of the two. Now we're going to do something interesting. In fact, I didn't even need to clean my brush there. If that red had still been on my brush, I could have gone in. But let me pick up some red again. Okay, I'm going to pick up a little bit of red. And this secondary color that we mixed up, I'm going to put the red down here and then kind of take about half of it and mix half of it with my red. And now we're going to get kind of an orangish red. And this is still very close to that. So let me add a little bit more red in there to get it a redder orange. There. So I've got now a fairly red orange. I want to dip in just the tip of my paintbrush in there to get water to dilute it slightly so that I have more paint to play with. And now I'm going to go in here. I'm going to add this reddish orange right in there. All right. So once that is, once I've got that, and again, I want enough paint on there so that there's no streaking or the white from below doesn't show through. And having done that, I will clean my brush, rub it along the bottom of the water container there, and with a nice kind of a clean, new, fresh, clean brush, I'm going to do the same with the second half of that orange, but I'm going to pick up yellow this time and mix my yellow into that. And that's going to give me the color that's halfway between the orange and the pure yellow. It's kind of more of a yellowish orange, right? Again, dip my brush tip into the water to get enough paint there, and put this down. Okay. It's a little bit dry, so I'm going to dip my brush again into that water to dilute the paint. And let me turn my book around so I can get that nice straight edge there. Pick up a little bit more of the paint that's still on my palette. There we go. Okay. So there we have it. We have gone from one primary color to the other primary color. And we created a secondary color in between first, and then we created what are actually called tertiary colors, right? That are the mix, the combination of the primary and the secondary. But you can see that it's this gradual change in color from yellow to red. Okay, now let us start do the same process with from going from red to blue. Okay, so blue is the third primary color. So let's begin with picking up some of this blue here, maybe about let me get into the screen, half of my blue here. And again, I'm going to put it physically in between, halfway between these two colors. Now actually blue is stronger than, the darker the color, the stronger it is when you mix it, the less of it you need. So I picked up too much of that. Let me just go back. You can always add more of the darker one. So let's pick up the red here and let's mix that together. All right. And what we do when we mix red and blue, we get violet or purple. Okay, so there, that's an okay. Maybe I need some more blue. It's kind of a reddish purple. There we go. So let's play with this. Okay, so I've got a nice mixture of purple, and I'm going to keep it there. I'm going to put some of it down. I'm going to skip one and put this down here. Okay. And turn this over. Again, remember when you rest your wrist on something, you can actually have a lot more control of the brushwork. All right. What I'm doing is I'm kind of pushing the paint around so that it has an even coverage of the paper. Okay. Having put that down, this is my purple or my violet. I'm going to go in and clean my brush nicely, dry it a bit, and now pick up the blue and just put the straight blue down. Again, so skip one and go straight to here. That's pretty intense, that blue. It's a nice blue. All right. And again, you don't have to be so super exact, but you can figure out what is a comfortable way. I'm adding some water because the paint is a little bit dry, and you can tell it's dry when it doesn't move well, when it kind of your brush kind of gets stuck. You can tell it's too wet when you see too much of the white underneath the paper coming through. It's too dilute. All right. So now that we have the two primaries and the secondary, the purple or violet in between, let's work on the tertiary colors, the in between ones. So I was we were working with this strong blue here. So I'm going to pick some more up, and again I'm just going to go to the side of this, half of this, and mix the blue in with half of it. I'm going to leave the other half here for the mixing in the red. So this becomes a bluish violet, okay, a bluish purple, because it's kind of closer to this bluish side, right? Let me quickly add this in. There we go. So you guys can follow along. Each time I'm doing one of these, you can always pause and do it yourself and then carry on with the rest of the video. And you see that it's a purple, but it's a kind of a cool purple. It's kind of a bluish purple. All right, there we have that down, and at this point I'm going to now go and do it the same thing with the other side. I'm going to want to clean my brush really well, of course, because we don't want any of this blue mixing in. And we go back to our secondary color, the purple, the violet. Let me pick up the red here and let's mix this in and see what happens. We end up getting a violet, a purple, but it's a really warm reddish violet. Okay, let's put that down. In fact, the dry could go even redder. Let's try that. Let's go a little bit redder. All right. So I'm going to go in with this redder version. Okay, so now we have only one thing left, and that is the greens, okay? So we've got the transition from red primary color to blue primary color, now the transition from, or the mixing of the blue and the yellow. Now if you see, this is still empty here, so I'm going to pick up a good amount of yellow, put it right in the center there between these two. And again, we don't need a lot of the darker color, so let's pick up a less amount and mix it in and see what happens. Starting to form a nice green. We kind of want to get that, we don't want it to be too light a green, okay? We want it to be, nor do we want it to be too dark a green, but so that's about an okay green in between there. And let me pick up some water, dilute it a little bit, and go ahead and put it down again. We skip one, right? So it's the center. Put that down. And then we have only a little bit left to do to finish up. And that is, we want to go from, we're going to work with a, let's first put the, have a combination of green and blue, right? So let's pick up some of this blue and work it on this half here. Okay, we've got, that looks pretty good. Kind of a darker version of the green. It's a bluer version of the green. So it's both darker and it's cooler. Okay, let's put that down. In fact, we can probably put some more blue in it, because there's a difference. It's quite a difference between this bright blue and then this green. So put that down there. All right. Again, you don't have to be super, super exact. It's more it's the color. It's the layer of color you put on top that is important, not so much the edges, right? You want to have this block of color very visible. And now for the final round, okay, the final piece of pizza. Who's going to get the last piece of pizza? Make your brush super clean, right? You don't want that blue getting in there. So let me pick up all this yellow and mix that in here to get a nice light version of the yellow, of the green rather, sorry. I pick up some paper, some more water just from the tip of my on the tip of my brush to make it, to get a nice amount. And Here we go. Let's see what this looks like. Ooh, beautiful. Right? So this is a more a yellow version of the green, right? This is so to lighten a green, we can actually use yellow to lighten it, and you can use blue to make it darker. Right? There we go. Ta-da! Here is the color wheel. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed that.